Welcome back to the Hank Strange Situation, Lifestyles of the Locked and Loaded.
Make sure to check out HankStrange.com. You can sign up for our email list and find ways to follow and support our efforts. All right, let's get going on this. Welcome back to the channel. I'm Hank Strange, and this is the countdown of our top 10 videos in 2020 as decided by you, the viewers. And I've got notes and everything on this, so you guys can see I've got notes. I don't know if you can see it there. No, you can't see my notes, but I do have notes. I want to keep this video as quick and as easy as possible here, so I've lined up a whole bunch of things. First of all, 2020 was hell in a handbasket, without a doubt. This was a crazy year for everyone, including us here on the channel. Lots of stuff going on. In our world, there was SHOT Show, but that was the last show of the year. There was no any other real shows outside of SHOT Show. We did do a little bit of traveling. I think we went to one place this year. But there were so many restrictions. We were getting hit by YouTube and all kinds of stuff happened during this really crazy hell in a handbasket year. But we're going to do the countdown of our top 10 videos of 2020 decided by the people based on how many views in 2020 each video had, with a little quick behind the scenes story that I'm just going to come up here when I'm going through the videos and give you guys some behind the scenes. I've got in my notes here, let's keep in mind 2020 was the year from hell. However, we want to give back to our loyal viewers. So the first 100 people to comment on this video, the first 100 people, guess what? We are going to send you our, and I'm pretty sure you're going to be able to see this here. There you go. This is our logo with the hand grenade exploding, and that's a sticker that we made. So the first 100 people, everyone has to be in our email list. I mean, that's just how we're going to do things these days. You have to be on our email list in order for us to send stuff to you. But the first 100 people to comment here. So the first one, go one, and then the second, go number two, number three. Make sure you're in the email list. If you don't know how to do that, I'll just go through it real quick. I am sitting in Lola's Tesla Model Y here. So you can Google Hank Strange, and then you will see the Hank Strange website right there. If you go to the Hank Strange website, there's all the ways. So if you want to go to our email list and you don't see a pop-up, you can click literally on email list right there, and there's the email list popping up. But you can go here, and this will give you all the info so that you can be on our email list. So to get back to this, to keep in theme, as I said here, to keep it going quickly, the first 100 people will get the sticker. Then the first 10 will send you our 2020 was hell in a handbasket patch. Let's see if we can get that focused in on there. There you go. 2020 was hell in a handbasket. We're actually selling these on HankStrange.com. So the first 10 are going to get those and a sticker. Okay, so, and then the first 5 will send you our other current patches that go along with that. So the first 5, you're going to get the other patches, which one is the broadcast patch right there. That's the broadcasting patch, same as I'm wearing on my hat. That's the blaster patch. So the first 5 will get that. And the first one, comment number 1 that's in the email list, is going to get a shirt from Ballistic Ink from us. We're going to pay for it. So if you can, let's see here. Can you see my shirt that I'm wearing? This is one of the Gun Nerd shirts. Let's see if I can, hold on. don't have enough room here in the car. But anyway, I'm wearing a Gun Nerd shirt. I'll tell you what, here's the easy way to look at it. So I've got the website pulled up here, and here's all the different shirts that we have on Ballistic Ink. And you guys will get to go through this and choose from which one of these you want, and we will send that out to you. So, I mean, Merry Christmas. Happy New Year from us here on the channel. Okay, so I want to keep this as quick as I possibly can, not make it a lot of editing, because I should be actually editing another video. But, you know, I was looking at some other countdown videos or wrap-up videos, and I was like, you know what, I really should do this. So I went and I looked through the stats of what our top videos are on the channel. that's how I came up with this, to see like what are the most viewed videos in 2020. So let me give you guys some stats out of this first. Our videos got 3,841,838 views in 2020. So 3.8 million. Seriously, that is amazing. Sorry, I'm trying to get my big head out of the sun. Okay, so that's amazing, right? 3.8 million views on our channel. That's 456,300 hours watched, that's amazing also. We went up 19,200 subscribers. We actually finally hit 100,000 subscribers in 2020. So big thanks to all the folks out there who subscribe to us here on the channel. If you haven't done that, please do it. You know, that's amazing. 2020, like I said, it's just like hell in a handbasket, roller coaster ride. Okay, so to keep this moving here, I'm gonna go to the number 10 video. The number 10 video of 2020 is custom leather holster making, the McDaniel 2 rig, and that's one of our How It's Made videos, and it came out in November of 2015, and it got 47,000 views, actually 47,845 views in 2020, and I will, I'll flip over here. There it goes, custom leather holster making. I'm not really to make this fast on the edit. I'm not going to run into much of this, but I am going to link in the description to each one of these videos. So there it goes. That's myself and Sam Andrews. Sam Andrews has been a big part of our channel. You guys will hear about him here in the countdown. That's in his old shop, which was basically a garage outside of his home when I met him. This video is from 2015, as I said. You know what I could tell you guys about Sam Andrews just real quick? This is an incredibly talented guy. He's been making leather holsters for 40 years. He's very talented, very funny, incredibly hardworking. And when I look back at 2015, this video overall has 228,000 views. To think of the amount of work that we've put in, it's amazing. And most of the credit has to go to Sam Andrews and just how hard he works. Even when he's not in the shop, he takes his work home with him, and he's trying to get those holsters out to you guys as quickly as possible. So I could just say that when I think back that he was in that shop, as we go forward here, you guys will see he's not in the shop anymore. But to think back that, you know, when we first met, and we met before this, I think we met at least a year or so before 2015. And he used to live actually just maybe 10 minutes away from where I am. I'm really proud of, you know, how far our relationship has come and how much Sam has been able to do, but it's mostly up to him. So I just have to say that all I did was run the cameras with Lola's help when we make those videos. Okay, number 9. I'm going to go to number 9, and I am going to flip over here to my screen for number 9 to show you guys. Number 9 is Tippmann Armory 9mm Gatling, and that's my friend 35. Trey from Aries Training. There you go. That's Trey from Aries Training Facility in Leesburg here on this video. And this 9mm Gatling gun from Tippmann Armory, if we skip forward here, that's actually Trey's gun. And Lola was filming on this one, so it's not even me. This video, the credit goes all to Lola. There it goes. That's an amazing, very cool gun. So that video came out in August of 2019, and it has 47,000 views, very close to the first one, the number 10 video, but it got 47,300, something like that was the number. And check it out. There's Lola. So I'm filming there, and Lola was shooting it. Actually, here, let's go back. Lola really loved this. This was her idea to shoot this video, so I have to give her the credit for it. I think it was a cool gun, but Lola insisted on doing this video, and she had a great time with that. I just have to say that for sure, that's a fun video, and thanks to everyone that watched that. Number 8 on this list Is the 5.12 tactical 22 Magnum rifle from CZ USA. That's coming in at number 8, and let's take a look at that. So here we go. Here's a little quick look at the video here. This was a very nice gun. 22 Magnum is one of my favorite rounds, and in the rifle format here, with this ACSS reticle that you guys see, that is from Primary Arms. That was a great gun. I had a lot of fun shooting that gun. We didn't really have it for a very long time. This was back in February of 2016. So we got the rifle. Like I said, I'm a fan. I shot it. It really worked great. And then we sent it back to CZ. At that time, we had a relationship with CZ where they would send us stuff to test. So we sent that back. And, you know, like I said, no problems with the 5.12. It was great. You can see all of that reflected in the video. They sent us a CZ Shadow. And you might see this a couple of times here on this particular list. They sent us a CZ-75 Shadow after that, which is a very nice gun. And I know there's lots of CZ fans out there. There was something wrong with ours, and it didn't really work the way that it should have. And I do what I usually do here. If you buy a gun and something's wrong with it, you talk to the company to see if you're doing something wrong or what's going on. They said that we needed to send it back to them. We sent it back, and we expected to get it back, and then we would do our video. We would probably say in that video that, hey, there was something up with this. We had to send it back and get it back, etc. Never got the Shadow back from CZ, and they stopped talking to us. So it's just one of those weird things that happens sometimes when you do this stuff that I guess they weren't happy because we found or we came across a problem with their gun, and instead of fixing that and sending it back to us, they just decided to stop talking to us. So if you really look, you'll see we never did anything again with CZ outside of stuff that, so for example, I have a Scorpion and I've done lots of stuff on that, and I will do stuff with CZ if I either buy it or someone I know has one and I could borrow it, or I could get it from somewhere else. Just for whatever weird reason, I don't know, they just weren't happy because we sent that gun back and then didn't deal with us anymore. So that's how this goes. I mean, you know, it is what it is. All right. We cannot do anything about that. And as you'll see, we'll get that in other places. Actually, number 7 is one of those. So number 7 is the Diamondback DB AR-15 pistol, which has 53,000 views. And let me see if I could pull it up here. So here we go. This was back when I had the old school logo. So you guys can see that. Now, this was a really beautiful AR. Oh, look at that. I've got Eric in my intros back then in 2014. So there goes the gun. Really nice gun. As you can see, this had like the pistol buffer tube behind it. This was before the craze really took off with the pistol braces that you guys, there's so many of them out there. And that was, we've had some conversations about that in 2020. So this was a great gun, great color, good work from Diamondback. I think Diamondback is a Florida company, and they're kind of, I think that, you know, with the AR pattern rifles that they made, there were no problems. I mean, you really have to be bad to mess up making an AR, and they did a great job on that. I think that with their first pistols that they put out, there were some problems, and we did videos on those as well. And, we wound up having to send those back to them. We got them fixed. They still weren't really working right. And we kind of went through a whole thing, and I had to eventually make a video and let everyone know that, hey, these are the problems that we have with these guns. I believe that's back when I was doing stuff with Mr. Yakaz, if you guys remember that. You know, fast forward, we continue to do stuff with Diamondback, including when they came out with their newer version of the pistols. They sent those to us, and I did stuff with them, and they were a lot better. And you guys will see that if you look on my channel, you'll see that reflected that I did videos of those. But recently, Diamondback came out with an AR pattern 5.7, using the 5.7 round. I think it uses the same magazine as the 5.7 pistol from FN. And I was very interested in that. I really wanted to know how that gun worked. So I got in touch with them, through email, and I said, hey, can you guys send us one of those for testing? whoever does their marketing stuff sent me back a very angry letter because we put out those negative videos about the original pistols. Apparently that person never saw a follow-up stuff that we did where we liked the other stuff that they put out. They never saw any of the other videos. I don't think they even realized that this overall, this video has over 300,000 views on our channel. None of that matters. They were angry. They said they'll never send us anything for testing. It is what it is. You know, like I said before, I can't do anything about that except if I really want to get my hands on that, and folks out there do, which I think some people have asked me to check into that. I will have to buy that gun if I can get it at a good price from somewhere, or borrow it from someone, or find it from some other place, and then I will do a video on it. But I'm not going to waste my time trying to make Diamondback happy. It is what it is. You know, we just got to deal with that. All right, for the sake of moving on, the number six video of 2020 was the PS9 Dagger pistol from Palmetto State Armory at SHOT Show 2020. So this is one of the videos that's from 2020. Came out in January. It has 66,000 views. And let's see, let's pull it up here and I can show you guys. This was at SHOT Show. And I could say that PSA, Palmetto State Armory, had a lot of new guns in 2020 at SHOT Show. As I said earlier, was the first show that came out. These guys are really proud of the Dagger. They really put a lot of work into this. I think that there's folks out there who believe that the Dagger is just a clone of a Glock. And if you talk to those guys, I've done a lot of videos on it. It's not. Now, there's also folks out there who believe that it's a unicorn. It's never going to come out. I even made a video saying it's coming out now. And basically, PSA was out there selling the Dagger, but they didn't deliver it because at the last minute in manufacturing, they found a part that they ordered from somewhere else that had issues, and they just didn't really want to put that out there with those issues. So they held it up and they made everything right with the folks who had bought them. They told them they could get their money refunded, you know, or, you know, they would do some special stuff for them, I guess, if they waited. And those pistols will be coming out. That's what I hear from PSA. And I know it's disappointing for people out there to not have those guns out yet. These affordable guns in the Glock category, for folks to be able to get their hands on. But I think it's coming, and I think we would all rather that they do it right and put it out there and there's no problems with it and they don't have to do revision. So there you go. I mean, that's, you know, that's the story. That's the behind the scenes on that one. We just have to stay tuned to that. So, I mean, you know, I'm sure there's people out there that are going to say, yeah, you know, it's a unicorn. I think it's really going to happen, but you want to get it done right. Okay, so let's go to number five. Custom leather holster making Monarch shoulder rig, how it's made. And that was from February 2017. And that actually has 79,000 views. And here we go. I will flip this over here and hit the play button on this. This is my, I'm trying to like save time, but I don't know how much time I'm exactly saving with all of this. So there you go. In the background, you can see there's a massive Magnificent Seven poster, and this is actually in Sam Andrews' new shop, which is now in St. Augustine, for anyone who doesn't know about that. And that's a much bigger Hank Strange there. Sam still looks the same because he works real hard. So the behind the scenes I could say here, if you don't know this, Sam Andrews actually made all the holsters on that Magnificent Seven remake movie. That's really cool. Even cooler than that, when the movie first premiered, Lola and myself, we went up to, I think we went with our kids also. We went up to St. Augustine and we watched the movie premiere in St. Augustine at a movie theater there. And Sam was there as well. He was all dressed up like a cowboy and everything. It was great. I know everyone will probably have their reviews on the movie itself, but I thought it was an awesome experience because everyone in the crowd of the movie theater kept saying, like, who was that guy that came and talked to you, you know? And Sam was like a big celebrity, and I was telling everyone those are his holsters in this movie. And that, for me personally, really made the movie because I know all the work that he put into it, and I was just really proud of him. So, yeah, that's awesome. That's our number five. Let's go to number four. Number four is actually a pretty big video here on the channel. It is Before You Buy That Cheap AK-47 with Jim Fuller of Rifle Dynamics, and that came out in May 2016, and it has 106,000 views in 2020. And if you look at it there, it's got about, it's over 500,000, 575,000 views since we put the video out. And yes, that is my friend Mixflip there in the video with me. And of course, the star of the video, let me skip forward here, is Jim Fuller. And this is when he was still with Rifle Dynamics. So if you want to know the story on this particular video, I believe that this happened in May. I was actually in Las Vegas for the broadcasting show. So I go to Vegas a couple times a year. I go there for SHOT Show. First, I go there for SEMA Show. That's the car show, which I'm, if you know me, I'm into cars. And you could check out all my car stuff on Strangerpalooza. But I go for SEMA. Then we go to SHOT Show in January. SEMA's in November. And then around May-ish, I go back to Vegas again for the broadcasting show because I consider myself a broadcaster. Mixflip at that time lived in Las Vegas, and he also goes to that show, and we hung out. And I knew that Rifle Dynamics obviously was there in Vegas, and on a whim, we were like, let's see if we can go visit Jim Fuller. I didn't intend on filming this video. That's why it's so terrible. A lot of people tell me that the filming is horrible on this video, but I didn't intend to film it. Mixflip was like, you can't talk to Jim Fuller and not record it. So he insisted that I record it. We shot the video. I'm really glad that I did. And it's a great primer for folks out there who are interested in AK-47 to hear it from the mouth of the man, the myth, the legend, Jim Fuller. So I'm really glad that I did that. Big shout out to Mixflip, you know, for encouraging me to do that. Okay, let's see. Let's go to the next one. Number three, another Andrew's Custom Leather video. And it's leather holster making Western Cowboy Fast Draw Rig, how it's made. And that was in May of 2019. And it has 133,000 views in 2020. Let's flip over to that. As you can see, that's obviously is back with Sam Andrews, which we do videos with him several times a year. Overall, that video has 312,000 views. And this is on a cowboy rig, which this is a really fancy, ornate. Sam doesn't actually do this ornate carving of the leather. There is he has a young man over there named Dominic that does that kind of work, and I have a separate video on that, but it was just really beautiful. You know, I don't have any of the cowboy style guns, right? But like single action army stuff. But man, if I got one of those, which I think probably if you're a real gun collector, you should have at least one at some point in your life. I would get a rig like this for it just to show it off. It was really so beautiful. The amount of work, the time that goes into this, and this wasn't even like the fanciest one. It was just amazing. It was just amazing to me. And I'm so happy that there's folks out there that enjoy these videos. You know, because if you had any idea of the kind of sweat that we have to go through because of the glues and all those different things that Sam uses, there's actually, you know, they don't close it off and have air conditioning running there. So it's literally, they've got vent fans and they've got to open up stuff. But when we're doing the videos, we have to shut down the doors. So he has all the doors open for venting, and we've got to shut everything down. And it is so hot. I'm telling you, it's really, really difficult. And this is why Sam stays so skinny. You know, I don't know, man. I don't know how to tell you guys that you're really getting a bargain when you buy stuff from Andrew's Custom Leather, because the work that goes into that is amazing. Okay, number two is actually one of the videos from this year. And other than that PSA video from SHOT Show, this is one of the videos from this year that's in the countdown. It's actually a new video. It's Who Does ATF Go After? Retired Agent Answers, and that went up on December 4th of 2020, and it has 133,000 views. This is one of the funniest things to me about this video. The thumbnail, as you can see right there, that I made for this video. Actually, I don't know if anyone noticed that, but that is actually my friend Brandon Herrera with an AK-50 shirt on getting arrested. This is all Photoshop. It's all Photoshop. I can promise you guys that. But... That's really a funny thumbnail, and I think maybe that has something to do with some of the success of that video. But in the video, as you can see there, it's actually going to a commercial right now. Watch all the commercials that help support us here on the channel. But so if you can see this, this is Vincent Cefalu that we had on the podcast about a month ago. Vincent is a retired agent with the ATF. He worked for them for close to 30 years and then retired. And he was an undercover agent. He actually reached out to us before when he put out a book to come on the show, and it just didn't work out. And then we wound up having him come on in the beginning of December, and we did this podcast. And I pulled out snippets from that because not everyone looks at the podcast channel, which is Lifestyles of the Locked and Loaded on YouTube. Not everyone looks at that. Those are longer. We do it for 2 hours. We do it five times a week. So not everyone watches that. And I pulled out these snippets, and most of them have been very popular, divided on what people think about it. Some people hate Vincent. They hate the ATF, which I completely understand. I'm not a fan of the ATF. I believe we should abolish the ATF. But he was a great guest and, you know, very honest from his point of view. Now, I know there's folks out there who've looked at the videos and they're like, well, what is this guy doesn't know what he's talking about. I think we are more in the loop. He retired about 6 years ago. We're more in the loop of what's going on with the ATF lately than Vincent actually was. And there are even points in there that we were arguing with him of things that he said the ATF is not, wasn't built for that purpose, and they're not doing those things, and it just wasn't true. So some folks have said, don't ever have that guy back on. Some people have said, please have him back on. And we're actually working on getting him back and doing another podcast with him and Mike Deddy, who wrote a book about guns going across the border because he was involved in that from the FFL side of it. So we will do that. And I know there's going to be people who aren't happy about that. But, you know, I'm glad we put the video up, and I'm very curious to see what Vince thinks about this stuff now when we put that back out. All right, let's go on to the number one video, which is custom leather holster making saddle style pancake, how it's made. That was from April 2014. And this year alone, this video has 618,000 views. That's right. This video, here it goes. And this is, I think, probably the first how it's made video I did with Sam Andrews. There you can see a young, skinny Hank Strange. You know, this video itself is over 1.5 million views, which is amazing to me. 1.5 million views, by far our biggest video, the first how it's made video that I did with Sam. And I have to say that if you don't know this, a lot of people don't realize that Sam Andrews is the voice of the intro of all these videos. So when you came into this video today, you heard Sam Andrews. He was, like I said, he was just my neighbor. And a friend of mine said, hey, this guy's doing some really cool stuff. You should go see him. I think the first video we did was kind of like a primer for if you want to buy something, what are all the different leathers and, you know, styles of stuff like that. And I did one or two videos with him first before we actually did this video. You know, it was really tough. This video itself, it was a long video. We shot a lot of footage. It was tough to edit it down to the 33 minutes that it is. And especially in those days, everyone was doing 2 minute videos, 5 minutes at the most. I mean, it's literally like documentary level. And I know it's not the best, probably not the best in terms of production or editing video that we've done, but I'm really glad that we did this. Not just because this video is so big and it really helps to move my channel forward, but just that it started off this whole thing with us on the channel doing these how it's made videos. And I'm glad that Sam took so much time out of his schedule of making holsters. And it's really done a lot for myself and Sam. And we're really proud of what we're doing here. So I want to thank the folks who watch this, the folks who share it. Sam for being the voice of the intro. I mean, he could easily, you know, narrate books or something like that and just make a lot of money off of his voice. That is his real voice. Number one question that people ask, and people even tell me in the comments that they look at these videos to hear Sam talk and they fall asleep listening to his voice because it's so soothing or whatever. It's weird and funny to both myself and Sam, but I'm glad I did it. We've done a lot of videos here on our channel. We've done a lot of different kinds of videos, and we're always experimenting. It would have been really easy for me to just only make how it's made videos, but there's so many things that I'm interested in. But I am very proud of this. And to be honest with you, everything that we make, I am happy and proud to make these videos and put it out there in the world. I know this has probably gone on for a little while. I've got a bunch of editing that I need to do. I'm here at the house, working from home. So I just wanted to get this out before 2020 finally kicks out of here. Some of you will be watching this in 2021. Let us know what video was your favorite video of this year. It doesn't have to be one that was necessarily in our top 10. You might have a video you thought was great, but let us know, you know, regardless of whether it was in or out of the list, what was your favorite story that I just gave? Or I don't know. You can tell me what your worst story was. And what would you like to see us do more of in 2021? Leave comments. Please support us on Patreon. We appreciate all those people that do that. Check out our podcast on Lifestyles of the Locked and Loaded. Don't forget to leave your comments. We're going to give away those stickers and patches and the shirt and all that kind of stuff as our way of giving back. I want to thank everyone that works with the channel, all the folks who come on, the people who send us things, the people who watch these videos and comment and share it and all that kind of stuff. I know it's been a crazy wild year. We've probably got at least another 4 or more years ahead of us of craziness. But, you know, I wanted to wish everyone a happy new year. I know that 2020 was hell in a handbasket, but we have to keep fighting every day. That's what it's really all about. Happy new year to you guys out there, to you and yours, to all the people that you love and adore. Hold those people close. And remember, I'm always telling people, you don't have anything you can't defend. So get out there and fight for the Second Amendment. Fight for our rights. Fight to make America a better, safer, more beautiful place every day. We're the ones that could do that, not all the politicians and all the jokers out there in Hollywood. I really appreciate you guys, and I look forward to this 2021. I'm Hank Strange on behalf of myself and Lola, the rest of our family and friends. Peace out. See you. Make sure to check out HankStrange.com. You can sign up for our email list and find ways to follow and support our efforts.